देशातील तिसऱ्या टप्प्यातील मतदान मंगळवारी संपन्न झालं. राज्यातील दोन लोकसभा मतदारसंघासाठी 72% मतदान झालं असून 2014 या वर्षाच्या तुलनेत या टक्केवारीमध्ये घट झाली आहे. तसंच पोटनिवडणुकीच्या 3 जागांसाठी मतदान सुरळीत पार पडलं असून मांद्रेत 81%, म्हापसामध्ये 75%, तर शिरोडामध्ये 80% मतदान झालं.
फ्रेंड्स, ऍज पर द रिपोर्ट रिसीव्ड फ्रॉम द both the districts, I would like to give you the figures of polling. North Goa in 2014, just for your comparison, it was having 78.64% voting. In 2019, it is having 73.92% voting. South Goa in 2014, it was having 75.17% voting. In 2019, it is having 70.15%. So state as a whole, in 2014, it was having 76.86%. And in 2019, it has crossed 72%. So at present, it stands 72.04%. But it is like, I would say, interim figure, it may revise. And for the by-elections in Mandre, it is 81.61%. In Shiroda, it is 80.09%. In Mapsa, it was 75.17%. Mandre is 81.61%. Shiroda, 80.09%. Mapsa, 75.17%. Coming to the EVMs, friends, as you know, Goa has already experienced 100% VPAT usage in 2017 general election. So it was very easy for us to educate the voters, and voters were also trained on using the EVM VPAT. We had replacement, I would say. During the mock poll, 13 CU, 9 BU and 28 VPAT machines were replaced in North Goa. In South Goa, 12 CU, 5 BU and 12 VPAT were replaced. During the actual poll, we had replacement of 4 CU, 4 BU and 15 VPAT in North Goa. In South Goa, 7 CU, 7 BU, 20 VPAT. So total during the poll, the replacement of EVM and VPAT is 11 CU, 11 BU and 35 VPAT. So percentage wise, the replacement during the poll is 0.67% of CU, 0.67% of BU and 2.12% of VVPAT. And in the by-elections of all the three combined put together, 2 VVPAT machines were replaced. In this elections, we had major focus on use of eco-friendly material. You must have seen that at the entrance we have kept a basket which is made of bamboo. Even the tray was largely made of bamboo, and these all were made by artisans of Goa, and we had procured them through departments of handicrafts. So it has been a very welcome change for this election. Even during the voter education exercise, we were trying to discard the usage of plastic materials. Largely, you must have seen our banners were made of cloth rather than flex item. So we had minimized the use of plastic items and maximize the use of eco-friendly material. We had major focus on creating good facilities for persons with disabilities. And largely, I would say that the participation has been very encouraging, and they were very happy with our facilities. And especially in the both the district headquarters, we had deployed accessible vehicles, which were having one vehicle in North Panji was having lift to lift the wheelchairs. In South, the vehicle was having ramp. So this was new innovation. we could not find more than that. So two vehicles we could find among the local entrepreneurs, and both vehicles we had engaged, and it was very largely received very good. And we had distributed the, as I told you in the previous conference, most valued voters to each one of our disabled voters, and they were received warmly at all the polling stations, and without any queue they casted their vote. And we had wheelchair arrangements at all the polling stations, and I could see the pictures or through webcasting that they were largely utilized very enthusiastically by persons with disability or old and infirm voters. And our volunteers participated very enthusiastically. The ramps were good. We got good appreciation from the people. The drinking water facilities shared, these were earlier also there, and this time we had put extensive focus on this. Largely we had very peaceful voting, and there are certain issues which arose, which all of you know, so I would like to touch upon those. That in the morning there was a tweet from Mr. Elvis Gomes about polling station number 31 in AC 34 regarding erroneous entry outcomes in EVM VPAT during the mock poll. The friends, I would like to tell you that the EVMs go through different processes, and finally once mock poll is over, only then when they are we are satisfied, only then they are put for actual polling. But this machine, immediately after the mock poll was done, erroneous result came. Again, they have done mock poll, another mock poll in which the result was correct. But when we got to know, collector, so he went to the spot, and we decided that since this machine gave erroneous result in the first time mock poll, second time it was okay. So taking abundant precaution, we have changed the entire set of BU, CU and VVPAT on that polling station. Again, as per protocol, mock poll was conducted on the BU, CU and VVPAT. It was coming properly as per the guideline. All the votes matched and polling was peaceful on that. So after that, we didn't receive any issue on that. Second, there was complaint on the polling agents of candidates of Bharatiya Janata Party sporting the names of the candidate with saffron background. In both the collectors, both the district election officer and returning officer, they took cognizance of that. Although the handbook of the candidate, there is a section 15.16.3, it authorizes that for identification purpose the polling agent can wear the name of the candidate. But since there was issue related to color, background and others, so both the returning officer directed their officers to remove those badges in their area, so these were removed.